you'll be taken aback by the beauty of Bern's surroundings the first time you see it. The Swiss capital is built on a sandstone ridge, surrounded on three sides by the Ahr, which flows through a valley. High-level bridges connect the city to high ground on the right bank and to the city's newer parts. Houses and shops with street-level arcades and projecting roofs reflect Bern's prosperity in the 17th and 18th centuries. And the charming character of the well-preserved Old Town is integrated into the city's everyday life, earning it a UNESCO World Heritage status. Bern's cultural offerings include the summer and winter jazz festivals, the Buskers Festival, and the Gürten Festival, which takes place in mid-July. Numerous museums and theaters cater to a wide range of interests, and street-side attractions include the Zytglogge, a medieval clock tower with moving puppets. Bern's Old Town is more than deserving of its UNESCO World Heritage status. The Old Town has remained much of its medieval character despite its location on a cliff surrounded on three sides by the stunning aquamarine waters of the Aire River. The streets are cobblestone and lined with covered arcade sidewalks that stretch for miles. The building's lower levels house shops, cafes, bookstores, and restaurants, while the upper floors are housing apartments. And many of the best places to visit and things to do are located in this area, including all of the bridges across the Aire, public fountains, old statues, towers, and the famous clock tower. The Berner Münster, also known as the Bern Cathedral or the Cathedral of St. Vincent, is perhaps the most famous building in Bern. Since the Middle Ages, the cathedral has been Switzerland's largest church and has played an important role in the development of the city's architecture. The late Gothic Basilica is a three-aisled, pillared structure that was under construction from 1421 until 1893, when the octagonal upper section and openwork spire were added. Bern's St. Vincent Minister's nave and choir have reticulated vaulting with fine 16th-century coats of arms. The exquisitely carved choir stalls were Bern's first Renaissance work of art. A Gothic font and beautiful stained glass can be found in the arps. The tree-planted Bern Minster Terrace offers a lovely view down into the Ahr Valley, and if you can make it up the 254 steps to the tower, the views over the city are spectacular, especially on a clear day with the Alps in the background. Another fantastic location is the renowned Kunstmuseum, located on the Hadlerstrasse west of Wasserhausplatz. There's more than 51,000 paintings, sculptures, drawings, prints, photographs, and films housed in this massive and impressive art museum. Built in 1879, it's Switzerland's oldest art museum and has an international reputation. The collection includes Italian Trecento art, Swiss art dating back to the 5th century, and international paintings from the 19th and early 20th centuries with a focus on Paul Klee, Wassily Kandinsky, and Pablo Picasso. From Jackson Pollock to the present, both national and international art trends are also represented. Other expositions come and go. Check out the excellent website for the most up-to-date information. The museum provides public and private tours. The Gürten is one of Bern's most popular spots, located on a high mountain with a 360-degree view located just south of the city center. The beautiful city with its towers and dome fly below with spiky Alps jutting out from the countryside below. You can also see all the way to the Jura Mountains from the Three Lakes region. Climbing the tower is free and the views improve with each step. Several trails around the mountain provide easy hikes through flowery meadows and dense forests. In the winter, the mountain has ski and toboggan runs for children. Finally, after all that activity, choose from a variety of locations and enjoy a high-quality meal right on the mountain. Every year in the middle of July, the Gürten Festival, a music festival, takes place. The Gürten is easily accessible by bus or train from the train station, but don't miss out on riding the century-old Funiker up the mountain. Bern's resistance-style Bondenhaus stands on the ridge above the Ahr River. The dome's central block houses Swiss Parliament's two chambers, as well as the National Council and Council of States. The east and west wings house various federal agencies and federal library. You are also welcome to tour the entire facility. When Parliament is in session, access is slightly restricted. The Bundesstraße is supported by massive retaining walls and offers breathtaking views of the Eyre River and the Alps beyond. Cafes, shops, and Renaissance-style buildings surround the square, as does the Banknote Museum. The Little Redoubt, a popular viewpoint in Bern, is just beyond, with an orientation map pointing out important sites. The gardens and a monument to Oscar Bider, who made the first flight over the Alps in 1913, are located next to this historic structure. The Natural History Museum, which is part of the University of Bern, was founded in 1832 and houses over 200 dioramas, including a 200-year-old preserved St. Bernard rescue dog named Barry. The dioramas are impressive, even if they are somewhat outdated. It's fascinating to see how museums were built in the mid-19th century. Some of the preserved big game is impressive, as are the Big Bone Show skeletons. Don't miss the Stones of the Earth exhibit, which features alpine gold, meteorites, and massive crystals. The beetle and evolution exhibits are also educational for people of all ages. Bern is inextricably linked to the Eyre River, a beautiful mass of crystal-clear turquoise waters that has shaped the city's life and landscape. While the river is beautiful all year and a great place to walk next to as a fresh layer of snow falls on the city, it becomes the hub of activity during the summer. The locals will be swimming in the Eyre as soon as the temperatures rise. On the river's banks, there's also several outdoor swimming pools, including the famous Merzili Pool Complex. It has several pools and a beautiful view of the Parliament building. Rafting and canoeing are both popular activities in the Eyre, and there's plenty to see from the water. If you're looking for a real challenge, try the Uder Schwalbe Rapids. Otherwise, a popular route is to take the train to Thun and then drift down the river till you reach Bern. Thank you for watching. We hope this list helped you find your next location to enjoy. If you found the video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to the channel.